welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Miami of Ohio is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 27-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Down right around the 36-yard line. That makes it 7-2. He fights forward to about the 39. And the short gain is enough for the first.
And that tailback definitely has a nose for that first down marker. I just don't think he saw the defenders, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 17-yard line. Zips it to the back. He's taken down at about the 21. That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That brings him second and five. Fires quickly and it's picked off. First and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. He steps out at about the 27-yard line. They come out in a five wide set. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
These receivers need to be ready because he's capable of really launching some passes. That one was just out of reach.
From the 27-yard line, it's third down. Out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Pass. Tackle made at the 19-yard line. That play could not have come at a better time.
Oh, that was absolutely the perfect time to go with that play on fourth down.
Fires it out. And down he goes at the 2-yard line.
Getting him the ball in the passing game creates real havoc for the defense. There aren't many linebackers who can stay with him in coverage, that's for sure.
And he's tackled at about the 7-yard line.
He's really quick with his lateral movement, especially for a guy this big. He got to the ball carrier before he could get out of the backfield.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Middle, got his back. Touchdown, Louisiana Tech. the PAT. A seven-play, 32-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
So our score, 7-0. Louisiana Tech ready to kick this one off. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. Here's a step in the maturation of a young quarterback. How does he respond to throwing an interception on that last drive?
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out.
I wouldn't be surprised if they kept up the pressure to try to fluster this quarterback some more.
From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. And he just gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
It's a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. This offense did really well with the air attack on their last trip out there. Let's see if they can do the same thing here.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
There's a strike complete. That's a great tackle at the 43-yard line. Louisiana Tech up 7 points. Plenty of time in the pocket. And he hits him hard at the 40.
You have to keep an eye on this guy, especially during passing situations, because he does a great job of getting to the quarterback, as we saw right there.
From their own 40-yard line, third down. He wants it all. This one is batted away. So they couldn't pick up the long yardage, and now they'll have to punt.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. Looking for the corner. Gets to about the 44-yard line. Louisiana Tech's looking awfully impressive right now on defense, but we are in the first quarter.
Yeah, this is about as dominant a first quarter that we have seen in a long time. But let's see if they can continue to play this well throughout the rest of the ballgame.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And now he's got room to run. The ball pops free. They fall on it. This offense can consider themselves very lucky to get this ball back.
That's about as sloppy of an option play as you'll ever see. The timing and the focus are so important when trying to run this offense, and it looks to me like they just lost their focus there for a second.
Complete. He's got room. He's at the 30. Knocked out of bounds at the 26. That's a game of 17. That makes it first and 10. From the 26-yard line. First down. Tackle at the 24.
That makes it second and eight.
and they need to get it to the 15. The cavalry's coming, and he's going to come up with a sack. Right now, he wants to get this kick away and change field position. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. After one quarter of play, and we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. The Bulldogs lead 7-0. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Zips it to the tight end. He's tackled at the 28-yard line. Louisiana Tech is up by a touchdown. They'll bring him down at the 30-yard line. To the 40, and they make the stop around the 41-yard line. He's got it out to his tight end, and he's taken down at about the 39-yard line.
Guys, I really like what the offensive coordinator is doing here. Throwing it on first and second down will keep the defense guessing.
Throws to the tailback, incomplete.
These guys, especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 39. Slings it. Brought down at about the 11.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Rid of this one. They'll line it up again on third down. Louisiana Tech is up a score. On the pass, touchdown. Call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So after some discussion, the call on the field stands. He splits the uprights with the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the three. Tackle made at the 27.
This defense has everything. They kind of have that blue-collar, workman-like approach, but they also have a blend of tremendous speed to go along with that work ethic And the better they play, they seem to feed off of it, and it continues throughout the whole ballgame.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Second down and nine to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. He's at midfield. Fires out to his receiver. And he's finally shoved out at the 41.
Well, I tell you, these guys have some skill players who can make things happen. They picked up an enormous amount of real estate on that play.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football and check it down or take off and run with it.
Quick strike and he drops it. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. Open field.
The defense was ready for that pass and catch, and they did a good job to hold them for such a short game.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's taken down at the 16-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
From the 16-yard line, it's first down. Throws this one away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
This is the eighth play of this drive. The 10. Touchdown, Miami.
This guy seems to make things happen no matter what kind of space he has to work with. All he needs is a little crease of daylight and forget about it.
He makes the PAT. An 8-play, 73-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He'll return it from the one. He's tackled at the 28. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Louisiana Tech is up 7. Zips it to the back. Tackle made at the 31-yard line. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Halfback hauls it in past the marker. And he tackles him hard at the 40-yard line. There was a defender right in his face that time.
Yeah, but great concentration by the receiver to come away with this ball. Nice job.
Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. They get a good 7 yards on that one.
That's a good completion. They didn't get the first down, but they picked up about 7 yards.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He wants it all going long. Can't make the grab.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over it.
That makes it third and three. He steps out at the 49. It out to maybe the 23-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Throws it, and it's tipped away.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid, fundamental pass defense.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 23. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. Throws complete, he's hit right away.
I don't know what game plan this offense is running. It might need to be reassessed by this coaching staff. The defense decided to go conservative, sitting back in cover three. They wanted to make sure the receiver was not going to get open past the first down line on that play.
He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Louisiana Tech up 7 points. Sacked.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only did they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
Down, and they need to get it inside the 47. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. So the offense fails to pick up a first down.
The secondary decided to drop back into coverage here, and there was nobody open for the quarterback to deliver the ball to. Good job by the D.
And he's tackled at the 30. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He's to the 40. Gains his way to the 49-yard line.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
From the 49-yard line, first down. He sails it long. Almost picked off. We've still got a half of football remaining. Louisiana Tech's lead is a touchdown.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Both passing games have struggled in the first half, David, and a lot of times you think of defensive backs being finesse-type athletes. A lot of physicality shown in that first half.
No doubt about it. In defensive backs, the ones that we like the best are the ones that can play on an island and play extremely physical, because most offenses are predicated around timing and rhythm, and You see quarterbacks all the time in 7-on-7s and all summer getting with their wide receivers to try to get that perfect timing. And if you can jam them up at the line of scrimmage, you can mess up that timing. And doing a good job of that, playing close to the line of scrimmage, you know, not letting those receivers get too much wide open spaces and not giving away those easy completions. It's been a clinic so far the first half.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk takes the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Fielded at the 4. He's taken down at the 23. The Bulldogs continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Throws it in a hurry. And down he goes, right around the 30. 7-yard play.
Hey, they picked up a nice gain of 7 yards on that play. Great pass.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. The 40, and he's tackled right around the 48-yard line. From their own 48-yard line, first down. Fights forward to around midfield.
Gain 2 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Fires quickly to the tight end. Tackle at the 40. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40. And now the ball is loose. And the offense picks it up. He tackles him for a loss.
Is out of bounds.
A man down, and he's in some pain right now. And this play is number 8 on the drive. This one's going deep to the end zone. He scores. What a play. The extra point to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point. Redhawks wideout out with an apparent injury, although he might make a comeback before this game's over. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll take it from the 2. tries to get around the corner. He's to the 20. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 28-yard line. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Wants to go long and does. Comes the pressure. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Kirk, if this keeps going like it has been, we are going to have one exciting fourth quarter.
I just hope we continue to see this kind of execution. It's a lot of fun to be able to watch these offenses make plays, and it kind of has that feel. Whoever does have the ball last and a chance to make a play could win this game. The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
And a quick throw, and he's hit before he can go anywhere. That brings him second and five. It's second and five here. Ball on their own 30. Gets it. He's in space. And they push him out at about the 39-yard line. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. That's a loss of about three.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 36. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's taken down around the 48-yard line.
You can see how comfortable this guy is with that football in his arms.
From midfield, it's first down. There's a strike complete.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Down at the 22. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Completes it across the middle. Touchdown, Redhawks. Play for the White.
saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
One of the things a quarterback's looking for before the ball is snapped on a post route is to see if he has one safety in the middle of the field. Because with one safety, you can use your eyes to move that safety and then throw back the other way for the touchdown. I thought the quarterback that time did a really good job of managing that safety and eventually making the throw for the touchdown.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 20. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. And he throws it away. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 20. Slings it. He's out to the 30. Knocked out of bounds at the 34. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he shoved out of bounds right around the 40. He's taken down around the 40-yard line. So at the end of the third quarter, we've got a stalemate right now, 21 apiece. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
He's tackled at the 32-yard line. Here we are early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight ball game. And every possession is going to count from here on out. Oh, and a huge drop by the wideout here in the fourth quarter. From their own 32-yard line. Second down. Here comes the pressure. And they get the sack.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Third and long now after the sack. Throws left. The running back's got it. They'll bring him down around the 30-yard line. They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Quick out to his receiver. He's pushed out of bounds at the 43.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Ooh. about the 15-yard line. Short of the line of scrimmage.
This guy's out of his stance so quickly that he's really a nightmare to try to block. We found out right here on this play.
Zips it to the back. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. From the 20-yard line, third down, just under three to go in regulation. And they get nice yardage on that run. He gets it up, and the field goal is good. He's to the 20. Tackled at the 32. The Redhawks have got to be fired up how this game is going. They still got a chance to win.
Well, you're talking about a huge underdog that's battled the entire game. They've got the football here to start this drive late with a chance to take the lead. You can't even imagine what this would do for this football team if they can put 6 points up on the board.
Second and six. Ball on the 36-yard line. They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. Incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Louisiana Tech is up by three. They'll take it inside, but the defense is ready.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established. And for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, it can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
Makes it out to about the 26. Miami of Ohio will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Has some daylight. Inside the 10. And that sets them up with a first and goal. The Redhawks using their third and last timeout. They'll lose a yard on that quarterback keeper. It's second and goal. Ball on the 6. Touchdown, Bulldogs. Penalty markers down. They took too much time.
Delay of game. Offense.
Under a minute left in the game. And he hits the PAT. So that's a five-play, 35-yard drive. And that's good for a touchdown.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Taken from the three-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 26. It's been a good one so far today. Let's see what happens here.
Well, now you've got to be thinking end zone on every play. You just don't have the time to do anything else.
Last time out, the offense wasn't able to convert on fourth down.
You know, the last time this offense was out in the field, they went for it on fourth down, Brad, and they came up short. I think as an offensive coordinator and a play caller, you've got to be very selective on when to go for it and when maybe to just punt the ball to change the field position.
Second and 10. Ball on their own 26. Got a man. Watch out here. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line. And they make the stop at the 49. Throws it deep. No, incomplete. From the 49-yard line. Second down. He zips it. Incomplete pass. This one's over, folks. Just time for one more play to get some stats, so don't be surprised if you see everyone trying to pick this one off. Airing it out long. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. And so that's going to do it. The Bulldogs take this one, 31-21. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.